Welcome back to Game Beaters.
You know it.
What up?
Oh, you found the 1991 building. The Demolition Troops.
Uh-oh.
Oh, you got Ron Jeremy back
Ron's
for revenge.
Back. Ron's back.
Yep.
He's sporting more than just a chubby.
Ron's getting beat, but not in his usual way.
That's right.
He's taking a beating.
I'm all plunder that booty. I'm all shiver me timber.
I'm a shiver.
Ron, I want to see you face down, NASA. Oh!
This is like some John Holmes shit, man. What's up?
Boot to the head. No, no, boot to the head.
No, no.
Boot to the head.
No, no.
Oats, oots, oots, oots,
oots, oots,
oots, oots, oots, oots, oots, oots, oots, oots, oots,
oots,
oots, oots,
oots,
oots, oots,
oots, oots, oots,
oots, oots, oots, oots,
oots,
oots, oots, oots, oots, oots, oots, oots, oots,
oots, oots, oots, oots, oots, oots, oots,
I like how you just pick guys up and kind of just push them away.
Yeah, that old picking them up and moving them around like that's pretty fun.
You know, you pretty much are Billy and Jimmy. Like, they're the same colors.
Yeah, there's a lot of...
Exactly.
There's a lot of double dragon in this, for sure.
Steroids.
There'd have to be a lot of double dragon in all these beat-ups.
Oh, yeah.
You know, double dragon kind of...
They set the bar.
You know?
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
I still remember that first time we got double dragon on this, man. That thing just...
There was
a lot of flicker and a little bit of slowdown, but other than that, man, that game just was awesome.
Gee, I wonder if there'll be an elevator scene in this.
Oh, yeah,
I bet. I wonder. I feel it coming.
I feel it coming. You hit the nail on the head there, Dan B. Oh, here it comes. Here it comes.
Always an elevator scene. Every beat 'em up.
Hey! Hey!
It's tight quarters in this one.
Yeah, it is. Just as Spider-Man 3 sucks balls, so does every beat-em-up have an elevator scene.
Oh, man.
What? That's it?
That's the quick elevator.
We just went up two floors, apparently.
Oh, we got some more clowns and Karnoff again. He's spitting fire, folks. He's a good rapper.
I got a feeling someone's going to try to get me to throw a ping pong ball in a goldfish.
I'm Bozo the Clown. Let me kick your butt.
I'll have you grand prize marching all up.
Get out of here, you clowns. Oh, face smash.
I noticed you couldn't do that with the girls, though.
Oh, they wouldn't let you face smash the girls?
Oh, that's an interesting move.
And I couldn't, like, swing them either.
I guess they figure you gotta play nicer with girls.
You can still...
You know, this is when Nintendo was still allowed to be...
Right.
You know, they... It's weird, because Nintendo had, like, a ton of, like... almost borderline racist things like Punch Out, like every one of those characters is a stereotype.
Right.
And like, yeah, you couldn't really beat up on girls because every girl was a, you had to save them rather than.
I don't know why they don't have a female, like all female wrestling game. At this point, they got enough characters.
They could, yeah. I mean, they're incorporated now into the new ones, the female wrestlers.
Oh, are they? Like in the. The new wrestling
game. Yeah, like I've seen where you can make your own and you can pick female and...
Well, that's good.
You've been able to make your own forever. I mean...
You've got to move this!
I wonder if it'll ever come like... Oh, shit, dude.
Another elevator scene. We're gonna go up a couple floors.
I wonder if they'll ever do it like in MLB The Show or anything that you can make, you know, different genders.
Yeah, good question. I don't know.
Like Madden.
Madden.
Maybe they'll have here in a couple years, they'll have the first transgender wrestler, you know. You won't know. You won't know. Is she girl or guy? She's both. You don't know. So competing, she'll compete in both, you know.
They'll just dominate, right?
They'll just go in and just dominate every fucking match. It doesn't matter who it is. It doesn't matter who it is. They'll just go in and just fucking dominate. That's what I want to see. That'd be great.
I hope there's a last boss in this I can talk for because I got a perfect voice that I haven't pulled out yet. But yeah, that'd be fun.
I think it'd be fun to see all the the white trash in the WWE universe have to try to get over a transgender wrestler. I think that'd be fun.
Man.
That'd be fun as shit.
Yeah.
I'd want to see him dominate, though. You know, I'd want to see him just come in and just, you know.
I'm surprised they never had, like, a wrestler who, like, wore dresses and stuff.
They did.
Oh, I'm sure they have.
Well, Adrian Adonis, he was like
a cross-dresser.
Yeah, and Goldust character got very controversial.
I remember that. I'm not a huge wrestling fan, but I've been around enough to know.
Goldust. At least they brought him out for the siege. He got his ass kicked, you know.
More elevator.
Well, that was a quarter table. I'll never forget the first time I played at the arcade at 7-Eleven, man. I was like, I was in heaven, man. It was the best thing ever.
Yeah, good stuff.
You could spend tons.
And there's people who are trying, like, you know how, like, DLC downloadable content's a big deal now? Like, you gotta download this and that.
Yeah.
People are saying, like, oh, the people who are defending that are saying it's just like putting quarters in the old days. Like, you'd go in, you'd put quarters in. So why not, you know?
So you can, like...
And it's like, No, I don't think so, because you own the game.
Right.
So why...
In the arcade, you were fucking going broke.
Yeah. Yep. But, like, modern games, it's like you can pay to win now. Like, you can pay to, like, power up your character.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I can see that kind of stuff.
All bets are off. All that goes nowadays.
Oh, yeah.
Like the new NBA game, if you want, like, them to have, like, haircuts or certain tattoos and stuff that they have in real life, you have to pay for it.
Really?
Yeah.
I wonder which PlayStation will be where it'll be all virtual reality, like PlayStation 8 or something.
You know? Oh, right.
Like in, like, 2035 or some shit. Where it'll be, well, it won't be like where the controller is the thing. It'll be like, well, how good is the, you know, virtual reality mask?
It's new, right? Basically.
Yeah. I mean, now the virtual reality, you have controllers and you can see your hands as...
You're making... Yeah.
It's getting... They're making headway, but it's here in another 10, 15 years. My goodness, it's going to be...
Oh, yeah. It's going to be insane.
It's going to be something else.
Yep.
Probably just plug something into your head. You know, just like put like things on the side of your head and you'll like be transported into that world.
That would be...
Not like piercing your skin or anything, but...
Right. I don't know.
Like when you go get a scan at the doctor, they attach dials to your head.
Could be, yeah.
More elevators. This is just like, how do we make this game longer? Let's put like 12 elevator scenes in
there. Yeah,
yeah. It's like, we're getting up on this level, man. We're all like,
Uh-oh. Damn.
Some shit's about to go down.
I wonder if these are like the guys.
Get off
me. At least they're not like actual Bobos where you try to jump and kick them and you run into some spikes. God, that was so fucking frustrating.
Oh, yeah. That sucked.
Damn, you just tore them all up.
It's just like all four of them just pile drive.
Okay. One actually did shoot his gun. All right, fair enough. Like, what?
Better run faster than my bullet.
Oh. Boy, that band kind of disappeared.
Were they a one-hit wonder? I think so.
Who's that?
Foster the People. That's all bands are nowadays, is one-hit wonders. You don't have, like, there's no VH1 one-hit wonders of the 2010s, because every fucking thing was a one-hit wonder back then. You know?
That's true.
I mean, you'd have one-hit wonders in the 90s.
Right.
But once you got into, like, 2012, it's like, there's no such thing as a one-hit wonder anymore.
I scrolled by on YouTube the other day a thing that it was like 10 one-hit wonder bands from the 90s that you didn't know their singer was dead, and it had a picture of Shannon Hoon on there.
Oh, like, they were not a one-hit wonder.
Yeah.
Now. Plus, Soup is one of the most underrated records of all time.
Yeah. I mean, granted, they weren't like super mega hits after No Rain, but they had a couple good ones.
Yeah, I suppose. Ooh, there's some nice furniture right there. I like that table.
It'd be a shame if that furniture got...
It's too bad we can't fuck it up.
Go to the VIP room.
Uh-oh.
Damn. Trying to get over there. That's a hell of a plant over there.
Tell you what.
Oh, man, those designers, they were like, what would go good in this room? What adds to the feng shui? Let's put a plant here. Move!
Is that, what's that dude from Street Fighter? M. Bison.
M. Blaster. Welcome, Combat Twibes. Do you remember me? I'm David, the Colonel from the 3rd Division.
The 3rd Division? Man, I gotta be better than those other first two divisions, man. Those are fuck twats, man. Fuck.
Now I'm a cyborg, and you are powerless against me.
Uh-oh.
Oh, snap.
We're gonna break here, folks. See you next time on Game Beaters.
Peace.
Thank you for tuning in. If you like what you saw, please hit that thumbs up button. If you have any opinions or requests, you can comment down below and let us know. If you haven't already, please hit that subscribe button. You can catch the finale of Combat Tribes coming this Friday. And then look for a bonus one-off episode on Sunday. See you soon.